हेलो, माय नेम इज आयशा एंड वेलकम बैक टू अनदर एपिसोड ऑफ अराउंड द वर्ल्ड। ऑन द इंटरनेशनल स्टेज द कंडीशन एंड ट्रेजेक्ट्री ऑफ एनी नेशन आर लार्जली शेप्ड बाय इट्स इंटरनल पॉलिटिक्स। इन दिस कॉन्टेक्स्ट इलेक्शंस इन वेरियस कंट्रीज ऑफन सिग्नल न्यू अपॉर्चुनिटीज एंड शिफ्ट। They also offer nations a chance to reassess their geopolitical strategies on a global scale. One such major election is set to take place in the United States, a country considered the most powerful on the world stage, with elections scheduled for November this year. Amidst the electoral buzz, current US President Joe Biden has withdrawn from the race, and in his place, Vice President Kamala Harris has entered the field against Donald Trump. The US presidential election is significant in many ways as it will address America's challenges and the demands of international leadership. This raises the question, why are the elections in the US so important on a global level? And what impact will a change of power in the US have on global geopolitics? In today's episode, we will explore answers to these questions. So let's begin the discussion. The United States of America, the fourth largest country in the world by area, is bordered by the Atlantic Ocean, Pacific Ocean, Arctic Ocean, and the Gulf of Mexico. Additionally, it shares land borders with Canada and Mexico. If we focus on the current events, we find that at the end of this year, the US will hold its presidential election, where former President Donald Trump and current Vice President Kamala Harris will face off against each other. The entry of Kamala Harris into the electoral race has made the contest even more intriguing, as was clearly evident in the recent televised debate. The discussion, which began with issues like the economy and immigration, soon shifted to the ongoing wars around the world. Both candidates expressed differing views on the Russia-Ukraine conflict and the Israel-Hamas war. On one side, Trump criticized Kamala Harris for her failure to stop the Russia-Ukraine war and even dismissed the possibility of a Ukrainian victory. Harris, in response, remarked that if Trump were in power, Russian President Vladimir Putin would be sitting in Kyiv by now. Similarly, the candidates held opposing stance on Israel. While the US is generally seen as a supporter of Israel, Harris refrained from openly siding with Israel in the Israel-Hamas conflict, instead calling for a ceasefire and the release of hostages. In contrast, Trump retorted that under Harris' leadership, Israel might not even exist today. In the previous debate, both Joe Biden and Donald Trump had adopted a similar stance on China, and a similar stance unfolded this time, with both leaders reflecting a negative attitude toward China. However, their approaches to curbing China's regional influence differ significantly. On one hand, the current administration has strengthened allies within China's sphere of influence, hoping that this united front will send a strong message to China. In contrast, during his presidency, Trump followed a best deal policy. Interestingly, neither Trump nor Kamala Harris mentioned India during the 90-minute debate. However, considering the broader geopolitical context, their silence is generally viewed as being in India's favor. In simple terms, a change of power in the United States is unlikely to have a significant impact on India. Regardless of who wins the election, relations between India and the US are expected to remain stable. This means that business ties between the two nations will continue to stay on track. Notably, Prime Minister Narendra Modi's upcoming visit to the US has been announced, during which several major agreements are expected to be reached between the two countries. Looking at the other side, even if Trump is re-elected as the US president, there won't be any drastic changes in the India-US relationship. However, there might be a shift in the tone of dialogue between the two nations. Therefore, it wouldn't be wrong to say that no matter the outcome of the US election, the situation for India is likely to remain largely unchanged. Now it's time for the special Sunday edition of our program, in which we will discuss other significant international news. President Mohammad Muizu of the Maldives will soon make an official visit to India. This visit is particularly noteworthy as Muizu had campaigned in his country with the slogan India Out. Reports suggest that during this visit, the two countries might agree on several major deals. The Russia-Ukraine war has recently taken a new turn, with reports that Iran has provided ballistic missiles to Russia for use in the Ukraine conflict. As a result, Germany, France, and the UK have imposed new sanctions on Iran, targeting its air transport. European countries have labeled this move as a direct threat to European security. The Israel-Hamas conflict continues to evolve with new developments. Recently, Israel launched attacks on nearly 30 Hezbollah positions in southern Lebanon, resulting in several casualties. It is noteworthy that the conflict between Israel and Hezbollah began on October 7 last year, and it has yet to reach a decisive conclusion. So that's all in today's episode. See you in the next episode. But before that, let's note down a question based on today's story. How could changes in US leadership affect global geopolitical relations?
For more informative content, like, share and subscribe, and do not forget to press the bell icon to get the notifications.